traffic. Kumasi is the second largest city in Ghana. Another, the capital for the Ashanti. The name is Ashanti, not Ashanti.
Oh, okay.
But officially what you see is Ashanti, right, because the British added the H. The name is Ashanti.
Okay.
And we just drove through this town called Konongo. Konongo is an ancient gold mining town. And alluvial gold is still considered mined here in Konongo as we just drove past.
Okay.
Kumasi is not on the on the plain, it's on the, it's a high rise, I mean, rise and fall. It's part of the, it's part of the general dissected plateau. As we come up a hill and then you are on a plateau, but there are, it's undulating all over to Ashanti. As you can see, this is how greenery Ashanti is all year round. It is right in the forest, and therefore it is endowed with several natural resources. Yes.
Is there an airport in Kumasi?
Yes, there is an airport in Kumasi. There are, it's, as a matter of fact, there are about 7 or 6 airports outside Accra. Yeah, there are, there's Tamale, Wa, Sunyani, Kumasi, Takoradi, and Accra. Who this is a second one coming, the seventh one coming on. Okay, so we have timber that is gotten from the forest. Timber is a, these are hard tropical hardwoods. We have timber, and the region also has manganese and bauxite and gold. For now, what we are doing is a gold. It's a gold mine, gold that we are mining. And the southwestern corridor of the country has the gold. That's a gold, the rich gold bearing area. Aside Ashanti, the western region and Brown and Ahafo, there's a high amount of gold. Just that the richest single gold mine is found in Ashanti, in a town called Obuasi.
Yes.
So the government is mining the gold, they're not letting foreigners mining the gold?
So is the government mining the gold and not let foreigners? Yes. No. It is concession given out to companies. The government has a share called the golden share. But that we know, like the brother was saying at the World Memorial African Ancestor Wall. Yes, we just have a very small percentage of it. I think Ghana government is 17%, I just have 17%. You know, the gold mine preceded the state. The gold mine preceded the state. So those that gave it out into mining, they gave it out to the Europeans, the mine, because the land was theirs, and we didn't have any country called Ghana. It is when Ghana became Ghana that we formed a state. You understand what I mean? It was a colony. So it wasn't a state. But after we became Ghana, then we now form a state and put structures to get in place. So whatever happened was, while the British were here, they took certain decisions that are very difficult to maintain. So they gave you the golden share. What it means is that if there's a takeover, whoever the government supports shall become the, can take over from it. If the gold mine is Africa for the Africans, and Africa for the African want to give it to another African American brother, then the government coming in, if there are two people bidding, then the whoever the government supports with a golden share will take it. Like in 2006 thereof, the Longhorn, there's a company called Longhorn. Longhorn, they control gold mines in several places in the world, and that was a British kind of company. They wanted to let it out. And there were two companies, Randgold and AngloGold. So the government backed AngloGold because it depends on the proposal, the business plan that you bring in, and the government supported the AngloGold. But AngloGold also ran into problems around 2012 thereof, so the mine was completely shut. Until about last year, somewhat late last year, then the mine was reopened. when it became completely shut, the town went into ghost status. If you go into Obasi, you weep. I was saying, comparing Obasi to Johannesburg, because the British saw Ghana as an exploitative ground. They came to pick and go. But for other Boers, they might have come with appetite, and all this. They saw South Africa as a home they want to leave, so they developed it. But they brought a system that controlled the black people, which was appetite. And even still, before they released Mandela, they negotiated with him not to disrupt the apartheid structures, the structures they put in place. It means that the structures do not directly favor the black people.
Right.
They can give you the power, but then it's like the brother was saying, the Rothschild, you no longer see in the bank that's in the Rothschild, but they are behind there.
Yeah.
So they don't mind whatever you make out of it, whatever fame you make out of it. It is what is coming to them. And somebody, I was reading some books somewhere, YouTube, and said, J.P. Morgan only own about 9% in J.P. Morgan. Who is the one that had 81%? Yeah, J.P. Morgan, but look at the name he's made. Everybody thinks it is his. So that is how it is. The gold mines are not Ghana's. But of course, apart from some selective employees, almost 95% of the employees are Ghanaians. The government gets taxes from them, from the Ghanaian, and also from the mine. The people that own the land are getting royalties. See, we have something in this country that the land, either left or right, as you can see, belong to a family or a chiefdom or a kingdom. Now, if there is a natural resort, if the land has all forest, wood, then the wood is not yours. The wood belongs to the government, which is represented by the state, represented by the government. So it's the government that can give it, or the state that can give the concession to somebody to cut down the trees. So that, and then, but at the time that the trees are being cut, you are deprived your right of ownership temporarily. So what do we do is that maybe you are wanted to clear the land and process, I mean farm. So they'll pay you royalties. The royalty depending from 6 to 12%, depending on the value of the commodity and also your bargaining power. The typical example is if there's a crude oil in this land, the crude belongs to the state. But you cannot be farming there at the same time while they're taking the crude. So what they will do is that you will be paid royalties, which is commensurate the value of whatever you want to use the land for. But when they finish taking out whatever that is in there, because it's an exhaustible commodity, then they will bring the land to its original state, like they'll fill it and give it back to you so that you have it. So by the temporary time that you don't have time to go in there to use it the way you want, you are compensated for. Yeah. Yes, folks, is anybody coming up for the introduction? The brother?